Just 5 games remain in the basketball season as we make our way down the home stretch. It's crunch time, and we're seeing big-time players make big-time plays and step up for their teams. I'm Aaron Pryor. This is Around the Rim. Let's get into it. I mentioned big-time players making big-time plays. Kansas, led by sophomore Anaya Thomas, defeated Texas last Saturday 82-67. In the game, Thomas scored 21 points for the Jayhawks. Kansas, as a team, shot nearly 54% from the field and outscored the Longhorns in both the second and fourth quarters by double digits. Anaya Thomas is just a sophomore, but has made a big impact on this Jayhawks team. She leads Kansas in both scoring and steals, while pulling down 4 rebounds a game, as well as shooting at a near 40% clip. This is the first team in Lawrence that was fully recruited by Coach Brandon Snyder and his staff. They're young, but have some great pieces, and were able to pull it all together for KU's second league win of the year. Another one of those young, important pieces to this Jayhawks lineup is Zakiah Franklin. The true freshman is second on the team in scoring and actually leads KU in minutes played. Franklin has made the most of her opportunity thus far and is only going to get better.
She has it, just very even keel. Never know what kind of day she's having, very poised and composed, and really responds to coaching well.
Kansas will head to Morgantown to take on West Virginia on Saturday afternoon. The Mountaineers are struggling right now, but that hasn't slowed down point guard Tynese Martin. WVU's star senior averages nearly 15 points a game at better than 36% from the field. Tynese is currently 4th on the all-time scoring list at WVU and is just 86 points shy from moving into 3rd on that list. Martin was recently named to the Wade Trophy midseason watch list, joining Baylor's Taya Cooper and Lauren Cox, Kansas State's Peyton Williams, and Oklahoma State's Vivian Gray. And speaking of Vivian Gray, I want to turn our attention to those OSU Cowgirls. They've won 2 out of their last 3 games and will head to Fort Worth to lock up with TCU on Sunday afternoon. Gray has been named a finalist for the Cheryl Miller Award and has continued to be one of the best small forwards in not just the Big 12, but the entire country. She's 3rd in the league in scoring at nearly 20 points a game while pulling down 4.7 rebounds and has turned herself into a 35% three-point shooter, something she worked on in the offseason to add to her game.
I believe she's one of the best intermediate jump shooters in the country. She can rise up and score over the top of people. She's added the 3 game a little bit more this year, and she's always been a great free throw shooter. So when you could score at 3 different levels, off the bounce, intermediate jump shot, 3, you're very explosive offensively.
As mentioned, the Cowgirls will be in Cowtown to take on a red-hot TCU squad. The Frogs just went up the road and won in Manhattan after finding themselves down by 12 points in the second half of that game against Kansas State. Lauren Hurd continues to bring it for TCU. Her 18 points a game is 4th in the league, and get this, Hurd has scored more than 20 points in 4 of TCU's last 6 games. She's dangerous. This TCU team has been a blast to watch this year, and this game on Sunday will no doubt highlight some of the best offensive players in the Big 12. Thanks for watching, everybody. That's all I've got this week. Enjoy your weekend. Watch all the Big 12 basketball you can, and we'll see you back here next week for more Around the Rim.